G'day everyone, welcome back to another episode, Sailing Quick Creations, where we're building a 46-foot John Pugh motor sailor. So this week we're going to get stuck into the aft cabin. I've got a lot of grinding and weld prep to do, getting all the floor laid out and trying to plan and make sure we know exactly what's going on in that aft cabin so that we can get all the welding and prep done before paint. So I'm going to get stuck into that. Let's see how far we get this week. Thanks everyone. So I'm just here in the aft cabin, and since this is where I'm going to be spending a bit of time, I'm going to look at doing a lot of work in the aft cabin, getting it all prepped. I've gone and identified a lot of what I want to get done. So just run you through some bits. So I've just been identifying, this is where they would have tried striking an arc, or maybe he's welded something on there to be able to pull these panels into shape before welding. So I've identified all these to be ground off. I was writing grind a lot, so I swapped it up and just wrote G because it was faster and more efficient. But you can see as I go along, there's some undercut here. I want to put some weld in there because that actually dips in a couple of mil. So that would have been a plate welded on the outside, and they've welded on the inside, but a little bit of undercut. Some more grinding. Want to put a bit more weld in these. They've tacked it all together, but I'd like to see a bit more weld in them. A bit more grinding. Yep. Grinding everywhere, a little bit of weld on this edge here. So that plate's on there, but it's not really welded to much. So I want to put some weld in that spot. More grinding. All these are solid steel bars that run along all the weld joints. That they're not welded together completely. I'd like to see that bit. So this one is welded in all three axes. This is welded on that axis, but no weld joining them on that axis. So I'm going to weld all that up. Same as these webs, I want to weld them up. So same as you can see up here, that's been ground away, but there's no weld. So I'm going to weld that up. I want to grind these flat because that's just been cut with an oxy torch. I want to grind them so they're nice and neat. Got all these bits of arc strikes. I'm going to get rid of them. A bit of work to do in that corner. All along the floor. Down here. So basically, uniformly, it's everywhere, even on the floor. So what it sort of looks like in some spots is that a lug has been welded on, and maybe they've used the lug to maybe use a block and tackle to lift the plates up into position. And then once they're welded, they've knocked that lug off. Or they could have used a chain block to pull the sheets into shape. But we're done now, we want to get it all finished. So I've welded these on the outside, that still needs to be welded on the inside. I love the laser cut profile on these, and you can see if it's enough light how close that fits. It's going to give a beautiful seal, that is. I'm happier when you did that. So more grinding. So there's a bit of work to do in here with all the spots, but we've got to start somewhere. I've been playing around with how I want the layout to happen. We've got a tape measure here, and I'm just working out what size bed I want. So like, we've got a lot of room in here. That's from the end of that plate there to the end of the other plate. is nearly 2 meters. So we've got enough room to put double queen or king size bed in. So I think it's just shy of the size of a king bed, but only by a few centimeters. So you might be able to put a king bed in this room. I'm not sure if I want these pipes coming down. I may spot them up. So if I just stick the camera up here, you can see there for those stanchion pipes there, little cleats. Those cleat posts come all the way down to that plate, and that reinforces it a little bit further down. Not too sure whether or not we need to go that crazy. We've got thick plates welded on the outside here. Could look at making up a reinforcement plate out of 25 mil thick bar. So you can see that's 15 mil thick. We can go 25 mil thick bar or plate welded on to that plate. So on the other side of that is a 15 millimeter plate. I can weld a 25 millimeter plate on this side and then have a piece of steel go up and up here, put a web going across. There's another doubler plate up here. So then we're reinforced on a double plate there, a double plate back there, and then come across to this cleat post here so that we don't have this big post coming all the way down to 6 mil plate. So that's not really taking a lot of structural load there. But if we attach it to that, spreads that load out there, weld it all the way up to that corner with a nice strong web onto another giant doubler plate, which spreads the load out there, and then just up to this cleat. So I think if we do that, we then don't have the issue of having two big posts coming down each side. It also reinforces that back wall a little bit for a dinghy davit. That's what those square plates on the, have been welded on there for. We can do away with those two posts. That being said, those two posts are not in a bad location because I can box them in and turn them into cupboards. Have some lights coming, some reading lights either side. So they're not in a horrible position. I'm going to have a chat with the wife, see how we think we want to lay that back corner out. But if we're not happy with the way they are, we have a backup plan. We can modify them and make it a bit better. So we're basically going to be putting a big headboard across the back, having a bed come out. The wife doesn't like the idea of a coffin angled bed. So the bed comes out and it's got two angles. Either side to narrow it at the end, make the room look a bit bigger. So we're going to discuss that. And the only other thing I've been trying to look at is the walkway. It's going to go in here. So if we go a double bed size, basically the bed comes to about here. So that's fine, it makes the walkway a lot bigger, but we do have the rudder post coming up here. Now the rudder design I'm going to be making for this only comes up a couple of hundred mil. So it's sort of just above this little reinforcement plate here. However, we will have a hydraulic ram with a tiller arm coming off of that. That will mean that this will inhibit the walkway. It'll be a tripping hazard because this will be coming up higher than the walkway, and it'll be have to be boxed in, and it potentially come around the corner, and you've got a big box there you're going to stub your toe on all the time. So with a double bed stopping here, it's only worthwhile to continue on to a queen bed, which stops just this side of that rudder box. So we can box that inside the bed, which would be nice. The limitations I'll have on that is as the post, the rudder stock post comes up, it needs to be reinforced back this way. So I have to weld a piece of steel back here, and that's going to come up on an angle to that post to stop lateral movement either side. So lots to consider. I'm going to sit here and stare at the problem for a little bit till I come up with a good answer. So yeah, I've got a bit to think about this week, so that I can get along and get on to the welding. I want to get all the welding done so I can start cleaning all this paint up, give it a blast and give it a paint so it looks nice and fresh. But I don't want to do that until all the hot work is done in here. So yeah, the last thing that I'll have to do with hot work will be to weld all these studs on. So all these studs are going to be welded along here. Get the angle so the light gets better. So all these studs will be welded along here, so that when we get our acrylic, it goes over the top of these windows with a gasket. These can all be serviced from inside the boat. But the previous design was all serviced from outside the boat, so you had to get on the outside, put a Phillips head screwdriver in the actual screw, and then undo it from the inside, two-person job. But also they put fairing compound over the top, and you would have had to have chipped out your fairing compound to be able to change out your windows, which is not what you want. So yeah, we've got a better designed window. It's going to seal up a lot better. But yeah, I'm going to have to start getting into some grinding, and once all the grinding's done, I'll be able to start looking at welding up the floorboards, all the reinforcements for the floor, and see how we go. So I'm going to get on to that. So it's been bucketing down with rain, and none of these little water traps have any water in them. So my limber hole drilling has done the trick. So we don't have any problems with water pulling up in the webs anymore. So that's a success. So now I'm going to get into grinding off all these little spots that I've labeled. So lots more noise. Well, I've about finished all the grinding. So as you can see, all these spots everywhere is all ground down. Last thing I wanted to do was to start putting that foam on the walls there and having all these lumps sticking out, and you know, makes my life difficult later. So I'll prep it properly now. It's gonna make my life better in a few weeks or months when I go to put the foam on. What I want to just clean up a bit better here is these little stringers that run along here. They've just been oxy cut off on an angle here, and what's going to happen is if I go to paint this, I've got all these little divots and grooves which the paint may not be able to get into because it's not a nice surface. So I'm going to run a grinder across here, take the troughs and peaks off, and just neaten that up a bit. I've got two here to do, and then up there I've got one there and one there to do. So we're going to tidy them up so that my paint prep could be a bit better. And then I'm going to pressure wash in here because it's filthy. I've got mud everywhere from this boat just sitting here for years. And once I pressure wash that, it gives it time to dry. And while it's drying, I might be able to have a go at grinding these combings back. Can't see because of the sun. But I'm gonna grind those combings back so that when I go to fit the acrylic windows, it's got a nice, soft, nice, smooth surface. There's no lumps or anything. So it can seal up with the gasket. So I'm gonna grind those little wedges. So it's time to clean up. I started scraping all this off the corners, but I've figured out there's just too much baked on over the years. So I'm gonna go over it with my wire wheel and really get all that dirt out before I use a pressure washer. Otherwise I'll just leave half of the dirt there and it was a waste of time anyway. So I'm gonna clean it all up with a wire brush, even though after I wash all this down, I'm gonna have to really get in there and get all this paint up anyway, because half the paint is not gonna stick. So yeah, clean it all up with a wire brush, then I'll scoop it all up with a hand brush and then pressure wash. Otherwise, I'm just not gonna get it all off. So I've just been cleaning up in here. One thing that's given me a little bit of confidence is that in these corners here, I'm finding the pink garnet. So this pink garnet tells me that at some point someone did blast all this and paint it. And the reason why we've got corrosion coming through is because it's less than 100 micron thick, this paint. It should be about 300 micron, which is 0.3 of a millimeter. So that they may have actually blasted and put the correct profile on here, which is probably why this paint has actually held up reasonably well, if you consider that this paint is actually probably close to 25 years old. So this boat was constructed in around about the 90s. And you know, it's not in bad nick for the time it's sat here filling up with water. So it's nice to see that, you know, there's a bit of garnet left over, and you know, I'll clean it up properly now, but yeah, the preparation was probably done. So I'll continue on with the cleaning and so I can start pressure washing. Alright, so this is all nice and clean now. Looks a bit better. So what I'm just going to do is show you by filling one of these up with water, and watch it all drain out through the limbo holes. I am going to be putting a die grinder in these little holes and just bellow them out so that they are actually on the hole. But it's a job for another day. So we'll turn the sound off, so you don't have to listen to the sound of this, and fill up with water and let's watch it drain. It drains fast enough. There's a little bit of a pool happening here, but it's still draining. Drains through there, and out into that side. I haven't started working in there yet, so it is just all pulling up in that web, under that web, and then across into that web, then into the bilge. So when I go and move into that area, we'll drill the same holes and get that all directed to the bilge. As you can see, no more water. Water's not pooling up there. And the water's not pooling up in there. No water. That's what we wanted. Drains all the way down, just like it needed to. So that's a successful job. We'll just pretty it up a little bit later. And we're all clean in here. So while I'm waiting for it to dry, I'm going to grind out these combings that are left over. I know they're going to put more grinding dust in here and whatnot, but I'm still going to be taking all this paint off and painting it soon anyway, but just wanted it all clean for welding. I can't weld while there's all mud and dirt trapped over all the spots that I needed to touch up. So get the grinder back in here, start grinding some more, and then we'll move on to some welding. Alright, so I'm basically finished for today. I am pretty happy with the progress. We've got stuck into it pretty good today. So what I've done is ground down all the welded tabs that were just sticking up everywhere. And got about 50 of them done everywhere. All up here. Ground all these little spots away. So when we go and put the foam on, we haven't got big bits of weld sticking out, which is going to make it harder to install the closed pore foam on the hull. So we've got all the grinding done. So all the combings are done. So it was the welded combing for those small holes. All those were still here, so we've ground them back so that when the acrylic goes against this hull and gets bolted nice and tight to the hull, it's got a nice smooth surface to bolt to. When I paint around here, there'll be a high solid, it's going to be a 90% solid paint, so when it gets painted on there, it's nice and thick. We can sand it back nice and flush. So I'm going to try and get my sealing surface down to about 0.2 of a millimeter flatness. That's gonna be more than enough. If you're using a rubber gasket, you only need 0.6 of a mil flatness. I'm gonna go to 0.2 because I want it nice and flat. And so it seals up, no water's gonna get in this boat. So we've washed all the floor. I've ground these webs. They were just covered with oxy, so all the paint can't get into those cracks with the oxy torch, so it's dressed. So that the paint will adhere to that. I did the two up there as well. We ran the water down so that we could see nice streams of water going down. And we know all those limber holes are working. A little bit more touching up to do on the limber holes. I was hoping to get some welding done. We'll get to that next week. So I've got these webs here haven't really been welded. So they're not really providing any structural support, so while they're there, I'll weld them up. I'm gonna put a few more tacks on these stringers here because they're just not strong enough. There's a couple of little bits that need welding, like here. So I've got a little bit more work to do in this aft cabin. I couldn't get to it all today. So there's not a lot going on in this room because it's basically just gonna be the bed, the rudder bearing, and I'm looking at putting a water tank in. So where the pressure washer is, I might put a 150 litre water tank along there. The bed goes on top, and then there'll be storage under this, so the bed will lift up on a gas strut. So there'll be storage under there, and the bed will stop just after this rudder stop. So I've got to weld in a rudder stock on here, get the bearings all set up. There'll be a few braces put on here because I don't want the rudder to flex. And then I'll have an attachment for an emergency tiller arm go on top of the rudder stock. But that will come later. So for the next couple of weeks, I'm going to be trying to finish this room off. And I'm going to put the floor in. Floor's going to go that way. Got to weld in some brackets for the flooring. Yeah, so I'm pretty happy with the progress, and we'll call it a day at the episode now, and we'll come back next week. Thanks, guys.